Good day, everybody. Jewel here with you on Saturday, September the 12th, 2020, with your tropical update. Man, we got big news with Tropical Depression 19. It may become Sally before Depression number 3 out here turns into something. We all thought this was going to do it, but of course, this is Tropical Depression 19 right up here. Now, we have another little system that's right in here, but it's going to be going down this way. Nobody in the Gulf has to worry about this particular system here. But when it comes to 19, let's take this off just a moment. When it comes to 19, it's looking like this depression is currently experiencing some northerly vertical wind shear. You can see some wind shears right up in here. Right in these areas here. Now, what all this means is, and all the global models, by the way, are showing this wind shear, and it's looking like this shear will affect this system as it crosses the Gulf of Mexico earlier. But, since the cyclone is going over the very warm waters of the Gulf, and the temperatures are very warm and hot, and it's a very moist environment, it's looking like all of the intensity guidance models still show it strengthening to near hurricane strength or stronger before it reaches the northern Gulf Coast. Now, there's some uncertainty in the amount of the shear that I'm talking about this morning, so we just have to wait and see how it goes. But everybody out in these areas, you are reminded, please don't focus on the exact details of the track or the intensity, because even from the National Hurricane Center, sometimes when these storms go out in a few hours, they have an error of around 150 miles for the intensity and around 15 miles per hour is what you can gauge that on. But no matter what, in addition with the winds, storm surge, rainfall hazards, all of this stuff do extend from the center of this tropical depression, 19, which is more than likely going to be Sally. I'm pretty sure it's going to be Sally. And it's looking like it's going to reach at least 70 mile per hour winds. That's just 4 mile per hour shy of a category one. And it could reach a category one, this little system, which isn't so little anymore right here. Now, it's looking like it's going to produce isolated scattered flash flooding across portions of west central and southern Florida and prolong existing minor river flooding across central Florida through Sunday. Scattered flash flooding is also possible across portions of the central Gulf Coast Sunday through Tuesday morning. Tropical storm conditions are possible Sunday night in portions of the Florida Panhandle. And I'm going to show you, this is all going on from the National Hurricane Center. And this is for the Florida Panhandle, where a tropical storm watch has been issued. Now, wind gusts of tropical storm force could occur over portions of the southern Florida Peninsula today. And the system is forecast to strengthen to near hurricane intensity by early next week, and it's going to move across the northeastern Gulf of Mexico. Dangerous impacts from storm surge, wind, heavy rainfall are going to be possible along the Gulf Coast from the Florida Panhandle to southeastern Louisiana late this weekend and early next week. And all residents in these areas, you make sure you monitor the progress of the system and keep up with the updates, because a storm surge, tropical storm, or hurricane watches, all of these things could be posted later today. And in a few moments, I will show you where the National Hurricane Center is forecasting, as of now, this track to go. This all for Tropical Depression 19, which is soon to become Sally. Now, we have Paulette over here. Here's a little dot right there. That's Bermuda. Well, what's going on? Well, Paulette is going to approach Bermuda as a hurricane. As I've been forecasting, You've known this for a while if you're on the Isle of Bermuda. Now, this hurricane should approach Sunday, tomorrow, and Monday. Now, there's a prolonged period of strong winds, storm surge, heavy rainfall on Bermuda beginning Sunday night, and it's becoming more likely you're going to get these hurricane effects. Now, Bermuda, a tropical storm warning and a hurricane watch are all issued for you, and the swells that are being produced by Paulette are affecting portions of the Leeward Islands, and they're going to continue to spread westward to the Greater Antilles, the Bahamas, Bermuda, and the southeastern United States. Looking like now, yesterday, top winds looked like 105, but now it looks like top winds could be at least 110 miles per hour with Paulette as it goes across or maybe just to the side of Bermuda. Either way, Bermuda, you're going to catch Paulette. Please be aware and please stay safe. Now, we're going to come down to disturbance number three. Now, we got to make a line through here so you understand what's going on, okay? I will turn this on, and maybe you can see a little bit of the center of circulation as it moves through. Maybe not, but there's a little, let's take this off right quick. There's a little bit of trying to be circulation right in this area here, okay? That's what's happening right in this area here. But what we have to watch is right now it's a tropical wave. You can see how it's going, how it extends. This, and it's very disorganized. All of these showers are going to be moving westerly down around the island areas here. This is what it's looking like now. Doesn't mean this is what's going to happen because it's still a few days away. But this is what it looks like now. Now, if it does get together, it should be coming up this way. But like I say, it's days out. We got pressure systems coming in, moving off. This may change a little. It may shift a little more to the north. We'll have to wait and see. But I would expect all my island friends down around this, all of my island friends down around this area here, you need to keep up with this. I'm going to keep you posted. Then, this is a totally different system. This is the last disturbance that moved off the coast of Africa. You can see it is forming. I do expect it to form and possibly just move up the same direction of Renee and Paulette. And speaking of Renee, look at Renee. She's just a little old, hardly nothing. Her winds are like, I believe, 40 miles per hour, but that's going to slack up and turn to around 35. Renee is going to disintegrate slowly but surely. But Renee's track has changed. Renee is going to move a little westerly, and then she's going back down here to bring rain to the island areas in here. But 35 mile per hour winds, they're going to keep diminishing. You guys can handle it. A big old shout out to all my regular subscribers and all of my new subscribers. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. If you haven't subscribed and you are into the weather, any kind of weather, please click subscribe, click that bell, and check off all to ensure that you get all my videos when I put them out. I would greatly appreciate it. Now, over to the National Hurricane Center, we can see this is disturbance number one. It's just a surface trough over the north central Gulf of Mexico. It's got disorganized showers and a few thunderstorms. A little bit of slow development of the system is possible while it moves westward and then southwestward over northern and western Gulf of Mexico through the middle of next week. It should go on down into Mexico. 2 days, 20%, 5 days, 30%. Now, that's one. Let's go to two. That's just this broad area of low pressure with all this disorganized showers we just looked at on the satellite view. Now, it's several hundred miles southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. It's a large area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and development of this is forecast as a tropical depression. It's expected to form within the next couple of days, while this system moves generally westward around 15 to 20 miles per hour across the eastern and central tropical Atlantic. When they're moving like 15 to 20 miles per hour, you know what that means, don't you? Not very much shear. The wind's not affecting it, so it's still booking across there. We're going to have to wait and see. Now, in 2 days, it's got an 80% chance, and in 5 days, a 90% chance. Then we come to disturbance number three. This is still more just an area of disturbed weather. It is associated with this tropical wave that's located near the Cabo Verde Islands. Environmental conditions support some development during the next few days, and a tropical depression could form over the far eastern tropical Atlantic early next week while the system moves slowly westward. But by midweek, the upper level winds could become less conducive for development. So in 2 days, we got a 30% chance, 5 days, a 60% chance. This is 19 is probably going to be Sally. And disturbance number two, good chance that it is Teddy. And we have this chance that three could be Vicky. If these all do get a name, we only have one name left before we go to the Greek alphabet. 19, right now, 35 mile per hour winds, pressure 1,004 millibars, located 25.6 north, 81.1 west, and it is moving west at 9 miles per hour. So, that's kind of a clue to how the shear is going to affect it. It's slower, and it is probably going to form, looking like from everything that I've checked out, a tropical storm, maybe a Category 1. We're just going to have to watch it and see what happens. And when it comes to 19, I have taken the coordinates from the National Hurricane Center. And while it's out in the water here you go, let's move this along here. Looking like right now, it's going to be coming in. Remember, we have that 150-mile spread that it could be. Anywhere in this area, right in here, it's going Lake Pontchartrain. It's going to come up looking like now in this area here, and it should have at least 70 mile per hour winds. It could be a Category 1. It's not that far from it. Either way, it's going to be a high-end tropical storm, and as it moves in on land all the way up in this area here, just a little east of Covington, maybe Covington, you guys could get at least some 60 mile per hour winds. Now we come to Paulette. The winds are 70 miles per hour, almost hurricane already. It's going to turn into one, folks. Trust me, you're going to get some powerful winds, okay? The pressure now, 987 millibars, located 27.2 north, 56.8 west. It's moving northwest around 16 miles per hour. And then Renee is 40 mile per hour winds this morning. But by later on, I'm telling you, the winds are going to die down to around 35 and keep on dying down. That's what it looks like now. We never know what we're going to find from day to day, hour to hour with these systems. But this is what everything's looking like now. Renee's located at 22.5 north, 43.5 west. And Renee is moving northwest at the moment at 14 miles per hour. But that track will change. Before we go check out tracks from the National Hurricane Center as well as other items, please click show more below this video for any watches and warnings or any information pertaining to any of these storms that may affect your area. Now, as we look at the tracking map for Paulette, she's still a tropical storm this morning, but it's not going to last long. At some point today, she's going to turn into a hurricane. And you can see here is Bermuda. It's going right all around Bermuda. It could be a Cat 1, looking like possibly a Cat 2. And it could, after it leaves Bermuda, turn into a Cat 3. We'll have to wait and see about that. But it shouldn't affect any of our friends up in these areas here. So don't worry. You should be okay up in here around St. John, Newfoundland, all of these areas up in this area. But Bermuda, you're going to get the wind, you're going to get the rain, you're going to get the surge, you're going to get all the nasties that come with a hurricane. Please prepare. You should already be prepared. If not, you need to do it now because this is coming your way. And as we look at Renee, you can see, of course, Renee is still a tropical storm, as we've seen this morning, but by Monday morning and by Monday afternoon, turning into a depression, and that track is going to change as it's moving this way. Now it is going to come back down like I showed you and affect this area right in here with a lot of rain. If you have any wind, it's not going to be anything that you can't handle. Now for Depression 19, soon to be Tropical Storm Sally, looking like by tomorrow afternoon at the latest, looking like it's going to be Tropical Storm Sally, as you can see. Looking like remaining at around that 70 mile per hour mark as of now. That might change. It might change into a hurricane, a low-end hurricane. Either way, that doesn't matter. It's going to be a high-end tropical storm. This is the track from the National Hurricane Center, and you can see where the yellow is around the panhandle of Florida. This is a tropical storm watch for all of you guys. So please be aware. Remember, during in this cone, it can bounce anywhere around in here. So everybody around the panhandle of Florida, panhandle of Alabama, down around Mississippi, and of course Louisiana, this area here, please be aware of what's going on. Stay safe. I will keep you posted and updated as I get new information that really may make a major difference and concern for your areas. I love you so much. Please share this information with your family, friends, relatives, and on your social media. It helps me to keep people informed and aware of what might be coming their way. And I appreciate it so much when you do this. So far as the other systems go, we've certainly got them out there, that's for sure. Possibly, pretty sure we're going to have Sally. We're going to have Teddy. And probably, more than likely, we're going to have Vicky. So, we'll have to wait and see what happens. I don't want to elaborate too much on this system at the moment. I want to give it another 2 or 3 days. It is still far out because so much can happen to change what it's looking like right now. But everybody in these areas, make sure you keep up with me and watch me daily to see what's going on with this system, because it is going to form, folks. And I don't want anybody to be caught off guard. I love you guys. May each of you have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you for the birthday cards. Thank you for the texts. Thank you for the birthday wishes in any form yesterday. I love you so much, and I appreciate them very, very much. Please, take care of yourself. Stay safe and be aware of what's going on with the tropical weather right now, because it's popping off. And may each of you have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. And thank you so much for watching.